Faith Rests Upon God's Character by A.W. Tozer. All things being equal, the destiny of a man or a nation may safely be predicted from the idea of God that that man or that nation holds. No nation can rise higher than its conception of God. While Rome held to her faith in the stern old gods of the Pantheon, she remained an iron kingdom. Her citizens unconsciously imitated the character of her gods, however erroneous their conception of the deity might have been. When Rome began to think loosely about God, she began to rot inwardly, and that rot never stopped till it brought her to the ground. So it must always be with men and nations. A church is strong or weak, just as it holds to a high or low idea of God. For faith rests not primarily upon promises, but upon character. A believer's faith can never rise higher than his conception of God. A promise is never better or worse than the character of the one who makes it. An inadequate conception of God must result in a weak faith, for faith depends upon the character of God just as a building rests upon its foundation. This explains why unbelief is such a grievous sin. It is pure libel against the Lord of heaven and earth. Unbelief judges God to be unworthy of confidence and withholds its trust from him. Can there be a more heinous sin than this? He that believeth not God hath made him a liar. 1 John 5:10. Our hearts shrink from the full implications of such a statement. But would not this seem to teach that unbelief attributes to God the character of Satan? Jesus said of Satan, he is a liar and the father of it. Unbelief says virtually the same thing of God. How then shall unbelief be cured and faith be strengthened? Surely not by straining to believe the scriptures as some do. Not by a frantic effort to believe the promises of God. Not by gritting our teeth and determining to exercise faith by an act of the will. All this has been tried, and it never helps. To try thus to superinduce faith is to violate the laws of the mind and to do violence to the simple psychology of the heart. What is the answer? Job told us, acquaint thyself with him and be at peace. And Paul said, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. To these two verses show the way to a strong and lasting faith. Get acquainted with God through reading the scriptures, and faith will come naturally. This presupposes that we come to the scriptures humbly, repudiating self-confidence and opening our minds to the sweet operations of the Spirit. Otherwise stated, faith cometh effortlessly to the heart as we elevate our conceptions of God by a prayerful digestion of his word. And such faith endures, for it is grounded upon the rock.